Hello students, welcome to this session. We were discussing PHH501, Atomic and Molecular Physics. In that, we were discussing the second unit, X-rays. In the previous sessions, we were discussing how X-rays are produced, how they were discovered, what their properties are, how they interact with matter, what are X-ray spectra, and so on and so forth. In this session, we will very lightly tread on the applications of X-rays. Already in various previous sessions, at times told you some of the applications with respect to the properties of X-rays. Just to summarize and put it out there, we'll just discuss some of the applications of X-rays very briefly. So as you might know, one of the most important applications of X-rays is in imaging techniques. As you can see in this slide here, various parts of the human body have been shown X-ray imaged. So this is because the soft tissues and skin is easily penetrated by the X-rays, but it is not able to penetrate the bones because bone has a very high density. So that is why it leaves a shadow. So the shadow cast by the X-rays is seen as an X-ray image, and this is a very useful technique in medical imaging. So CT scans, X-ray scans, they are very important applications of X-rays. Moving on. So, X-ray diffraction, like I was saying, you see, it is a matter of great coincidence that nature provides us with natural materials which can diffract X-rays. If you remember, diffraction is the phenomenon where a wave bends around the geometric edge or the region of a particular material. Now, because X-rays have such a short wavelength, materials which can diffract X-rays have to have a very small distance or spacing. The natural gratings like that we use for visible light will not be able to diffract X-rays. Coincidentally, it turns out that crystals, because of their regular lattice spacing, the spacing between such crystals acts as a natural grating which can diffract X-rays. So this process is called X-ray diffraction. And if you remember Bragg's law and all this, this comes into picture when we talk about X-ray diffraction and how X-rays can be used to study and analyze crystals and various other samples to study their structure. So as you can see in this image, the X-rays that are produced when they are incident on a crystalline solid, the various planes of the lattice and the lattice spacing acts as a grating, and X-rays are diffracted. And when the diffracted X-rays fall on a photographic plate and the photographic plate is developed, you can see the diffraction patterns. So if you know what is the angle at which the X-rays are being incident, and if you know the wavelength of the incoming X-rays, 2d sin theta equals n lambda will tell you what is the spacing between two different layers of a crystal. Suppose you know what is the interplanar spacing, you will be able to calculate what is the angle at which the geometry of arrangement is taking place. So different kinds of crystals interact with X-rays in different ways, and they diffract the X-rays in different ways. Analyzing the diffraction pattern will give us a lot of insight and information about the structure, arrangement, orientation, and even the composition of that particular crystalline material. Not just crystalline material, even amorphous crystals also exhibit X-ray diffraction. So this is another very important application of X-rays in elemental analysis. Moving on. So, like I said, X-ray crystallography, X-ray astronomy, it's another fascinating application of X-rays. In 1994-95, NASA launched a satellite called Chandra, named after the famous astrophysicist Subramanian Chandrasekhar, which carried an X-ray telescope. And this X-ray telescope was launched into space, and it has been giving us a lot of information about stars, galaxies, and other planetary objects which are emitting radiation continuously in the X-ray region. So analyzing the X-ray region of the spectra that come from these objects give us a lot of information about these objects. So X-ray astronomy is also a very important application of studying X-rays. X-ray microscopes, because remember, X-rays have got such small wavelength compared to visible radiation, they can probe matter in much more detail and give us finer analysis of matter at the smaller levels. Industrial radiography, like I said, medical imaging and all these, they come under industrial radiography and medical applications. Authenticity and quality control of packaged items. So suppose there is a factory produced item and to look at, everything looks fine. But when we look at the object through an X-ray, we can see the small defects, cracks, fissures and such defects in that material. So X-rays are used to study the quality control of materials as well. And paintings are often X-rayed to reveal underdrawings, alterations that might have taken place. X-ray spectroscopy has been used in analyzing the reactions of pigments that are used in paintings. So different paintings are chemically different compositions, so therefore they react differently on canvas. So we can estimate a lot of forgeries and underdrawings that have happened in a painting using X-rays. Airport security luggage scanners, they use X-rays for inspecting the interior of luggages. So security and all this, they use X-rays for scanning. Metal detectors, they use X-rays as well. Border control, these truck scanners and domestic police departments, they use X-rays as scanners and other devices that can be concealed. Drug identification and investigation of bones. This also, archaeologists use X-rays extensively in this domain, in medicine and in drug identification, analysis of the structure and composition and all these. In characterization of textile fibers, polymers and analyzing integrated circuits. For example, the bomb diffusion squads, they use X-rays to study the kind of circuitry and the kind of arrangement a particular detonating device has been made. So this is also one of the applications of X-rays. So basically astronomy or cosmology, fusion research, metrology and medicine and other R&D applications of X-rays, like I said. So if I had to characterize them very, very broadly, I would say materials, mechanisms, therapy and imaging or bioimaging, if you will. So these are some of the classic applications of X-rays. Now, X-ray diffraction that I already told you very briefly. X-ray diffraction is a very, very important tool in analyzing the structure and composition of materials. They can be used to differentiate between crystalline and amorphous materials. You can determine the structure of crystalline materials. You can use the X-ray diffraction to study the distribution of atoms and analyze the unit cell structure. You can determine the orientation of single crystals, texture of materials, measure the strain induced, the graininess and the size of these in different material compositions and so on and so forth. You can also use XRD to analyze the solid liquid samples, the transmission, reflection, capillary geometry in high temperature and reactive environments, the orientation or the texture data of various materials, the grazing incidence and the angles, reflectometry, and Kralke small scale X-ray scattering. This is another recent application of X-rays. And analyzing them gives you the data of how to determine the lattice parameters in cells. You can determine the graininess and size of various polycrystalline blocks and so on. So before I leave, I will just show you two or three images of X-rays. Here is an X-ray image. As you can see, this is a X-ray image of a two-year-old boy who has swallowed needles. Very fascinating and very disturbing as well. Here is another image. For now, we'll end this session.